Hey, what's up, everybody? What the? Oh my god, my hair. Let me fix that. What's up, everybody? It's James and Mike from Two South Crew. We've been on a little bit of a break here. Hope everybody had a flipping awesome Christmas and New Year's. We did spend time with the family, but we are stoked to be back out making videos again. We're out at Hungryland today. We're gonna do a little freshwater fishing. Our original plan was to do some kayaking and saltwater fishing, but you know, things change. It's just the way it goes. So maybe next time we'll get into that. But this is a really cool place out here near Jupiter, just west of Jupiter. Kind of like Corbett, but another area you could drive out here. You can hike these trails, and there's a bunch of like canals and waterways that you can fish. And maybe get into some bass. So we're gonna see what we can get into today, and hopefully we can put some fish on the line. Hopefully I kick Mike's butt this time, because last time he whooped on me. So let's get to it.
Hold up, pale sticks. I just want everyone.
Honestly, these shorts are sweet.
I just want everyone to check out. Like, I mean, there's a reason why like I call them pale sticks, because I mean, I don't know if you could tell. He's got cracker white legs. I mean, they're like.
Look at that, though. Dude, I've been working my legs.
My grandfather had more tan legs than you do. I mean, they're pretty sexy, dude. But like.
Thank you. What? My wife said it looked like I was riding a chicken, so because I only worked out my upper body. Now I started working out my legs, but yeah, they definitely could use some sun.
I mean, the pastel short shorts showing off the pale sticks.
They're Billabong.
I don't care what they're called, dude. That just doesn't matter.
All right. Well.
All right. Get in there, pale sticks.
Look at this. I almost stepped in this.
Bring out a bassy bass. What is that?
The dangers of being out here. Look at the hole in the culvert. I was going to step on that.
Oh, dude.
Look, seriously.
Whoa.
That's sketchy stuff.
All right, you can see that.
See that? If your leg went in there.
James's butt crack.
Oh, buddy, you want to talk about messing up some pale sticks?
Oh, hole in the culvert.
Damn! All right, let's see what we can pull out of here. Besides our lures. Alright, everybody. So, we've come to the conclusion that this area obviously doesn't have any bass in it. I mean, that's the problem. It's definitely not our abilities, because we are highly skilled fishermen. So, we're gonna move on, because clearly there's no fish here. And it doesn't make sense to fish in the spot where there's no fish. I mean, it's pretty here. Look at that. That's gorgeous. You know, but sometimes you got to go exploring, and this is the place to do it. So we're gonna head down the road here and check out some more spots, and hopefully we'll see some other cool stuff along the way. All right, we'll catch you later. All right, everybody, so here we go driving down the road. Michael says he feels a little weird, that he's not sure if he wants to be on camera or not.
I'm a little shy.
So I just am like, all right, well, that means start filming, because Lord only knows.
Seriously, that's so not making the cut. Just might as well delete it right now.
Why?
Because it's not going to happen.
See? See this?
In charge.
See the attitude we're dealing with, folks?
I'm in charge, and it will not make the video.
Man, bass aren't showing up. Mike's not showing up. I don't know. We're just going to have to see how this one goes.
All right, guys. Coming up on one of the larger bird species in North America, the sandhill crane. And you can see it, they're year-round residents in this type of habitat. They will nest in the marsh that are interspersed in this pineapple habitat. These are sandhill cranes, did I say that already? I'm gonna zoom in. I don't know if you can see, the sun is just at a terrible angle. I can't even see what I'm video recording. Anyway, it's a pair of them.
Sweet.
Pretty cool. They supposedly mate for life.
It's better than what most Americans are doing.
That's the shizzle. Anyway, sandhill cranes, people. Love it.
All right, everybody, we're at spot number 3. It's pretty cool. We're gonna check it out. Ooh, we got a little bit of water flow here. That's always good. Actually, some good water flow. Check this out. Sometimes this will push small fish through, and the big ones will be on the other side here waiting to chomp down. So, we are going to give it another shot. Michael's already at it. All right, Michael, show us how it's done, buddy. Fishing 101. First thing you need, a pole. Second thing you need, some sort of lure or bait. Third thing, the ability to cast this thing. Fourth, well, here, number three. We gotta get past number three, remember? The ability to cast.
I'm so confident. Check this out, man.
I'm telling you, and it doesn't make any sense. Ooh, yeah, we just saw a little jump there. Why we haven't caught anything yet? This really is an epic little spot. All right, folks, well, I'm gonna get my rod out too and give it a whirl. If we get into something, we'll get some video footage of it. Michael will continue to work on his casting skills. Oh, that's number five. Don't get snagged. All right, I'm gonna leave you on that note. Well, everybody, spot number three. Also not producing. Clearly there's no fish in these canals. I mean, that's the only logical conclusion. You got two of world-renowned fishermen, me, Michael, a close second, not catching anything. There's only one reason for that. There's no fish in these waters, which leads me to my next question. What's going on in this ecosystem? I think we're gonna have to get to the bottom of this. What do you think, Michael?
I'm gonna catch a fish, Scott.
Fish, a weed. He'll put something on the end of that pole. I know what I'm gonna catch, a buzz. All right, guys, we'll see you later.
James, do you think that the reflection off your super white legs scares off the fishing?
I mean, it's definitely a presentable argument.
It's like,
last time we went fishing,
holy cow,
you caught all the fish. As long as I wasn't near you, I caught nothing.
I think we're on to something. Can you put like some tights on or leotards or something?
Maybe I could just get higher socks and lower shorts.
How about low?
Yeah, we're just cruising along out here in freaking Hungryland, and it's just so beautiful out here. We're just like talking about it, like getting away from the city and the buildings and stuff. It really is good for the soul. One of God's greatest gifts is these just different habitats and the wildlife. Even when you're not catching fish, I blame Michael. It's truly beautiful out here just to get out here and cruise around and enjoy it. And, you know, I highly recommend it. I know Michael does as well.
I do, man. It's just relaxes you. Take a deep breath. Just look at all that nature, man. I mean, I love it. I can't get enough of it.
That's gorgeous. You can even throw in a breakfast beer if you want. Not while you're driving, though. That's illegal. All right, everybody. Spot number 22. All right, it's not 22. It's up there, though. Culvert fishing 101. Here we go. See this little spot here? It's actually kind of cool. Got a little flow. It's flowing from this side here to that side over there. I'm going to see if I can't pull one out of here. The odds are going down, but you know what? We're not going to stop trying, because that's how Two South crew rolls. We never surrender. We never give up. All right. Sometimes when the fish aren't biting, you got to make your own party. Right, Michael? Always gotta make the best of things, folks. If you don't like this song, you're not human. That's my opinion. Look, everybody, we found some wildlife. I'm gonna hop out. Can you see that gator basking in the sun over there? Probably making fun of us. You guys are the worst fishermen ever. So cool just to come out here. And there he is, just chilling. Relaxing, enjoying that sun. It is a brisk morning. It's a cool 75. But they're just cruising down the road heading to the next fishing spot and just happen to see this guy. Well, I hope you enjoy the rest of your day, fella. You guys need to know where the fish are? Probably in your belly.
Tell us, Gator, tell us!
Alright, folks. Another part of Florida's wonderful, beautiful wildlife. And he didn't jump in. Haha, he posed for me. Thanks, buddy. See you later. Michael, you're supposed to go behind a bush or something. I mean, right in the middle of the road? Wow. That's what I'm dealing with, folks. Well, I can tell you this. There's that wind they were talking about. It's actually pretty windy out now. That's why we didn't do the kayaking trip. But if we don't catch any bass today, it won't be for lack of effort. We're literally at spot number 7 or 8, and we're going at it. We're gonna fish this spot here and see if we can't get into anything. We haven't had much luck so far, but you know, hey, the thing about fishing is it can change in an instant. You know, you can be, and then all of a sudden, bam, and it could just turn on. So, hey, you never know. All right, folks, we're gonna give it one last shot. We actually left Hungryland. We came down, this is like Pratt Whitney Road. There's so many places to pull off and fish, but there's like a area right here, just right off the side of Pratt Whitney. You know, they got some good flow, and we're gonna put some baits in the water or lures in the water and see if we can't get something here. If not, we still had a great time hanging out here. You know, there's, again, Florida's cool. There's so many things to do, salt water, fresh water. So, you know, get out here when you can, and you know, you're definitely not gonna catch anything if you don't have a pole in the water. All right, take two. I biffed the first one. Happens a lot. I'm always talking. Mike talks less, I talk more. See, here I go again.
It's got a bit of a diarrhea of the mouth.
Yeah, it's true. It's true. I got issues. Well, you know, we didn't get into the fish today, but we did have a good time, you know, hanging out, getting out here in Florida. That's the great thing about it. It's warm all year round, so you can fresh water, salt water. Maybe next time. But you know what we are going to do later is our version of a catch and cook. Publix is going to catch it, and we're going to cook it.
Oh, yes.
We are going to do a shrimp boil later.
It's going to be glorious.
Yeah. Mike actually is quite the chef. I'll give him that. So we'll be excited to share that with you. And we'll also be excited to eat it, even though we didn't catch it. But sometimes we catch it.
But most of the time we eat it. Hey, look, we got up early this morning. We got out into the wild just as the sun was rising, and it was beautiful, and we enjoyed it. Although we didn't catch not a damn thing, but it didn't matter. We always have a good time together, and being out in nature is what it's all about. So don't matter if you catch anything. Anyone that fishes knows that any day fishing is a good day, no matter what you do. So get out there, enjoy nature, love South Florida, and that's all I got to say, man.
Yep, we will. Well, you know what, too? That's what we're all about here at 2 South Crew. It's just exploring Florida. Sometimes you get into the fish, sometimes you don't. But there's so many cool things to do down here. And we did see some cool nature. We saw some gators, some birds. So it's like he said, it's always a good time. And we'll see you guys in a little bit when we do the shrimp boil. That will be a blast.
That's going to be epic, baby.
Yep. Catch you soon. What's up, everybody? This is 2 South Crew. Not only do we... are we amazing fishermen, although don't let today be a judge of that.
No.
Amongst other things, but we are also plumbers.
Oh, yes.
Mr. Baranski here had a problem. Well,
a problem with my pooper. Not my pooper.
This toilet here clogged up, and you know what? We're going to go ahead and fix that because we're a jack of all trades. We can do it all. So if you need your toilet fixed, I mean, don't call us, call a plumber. But we're going to make this happen. We'll talk to you real soon. Well, folks, we may not be plumbers, but we made this happen. Look at that. Flush it, Mike.
The pooper shooter works.
Look at that. Bam! You saw the hole, and we plugged it. So 2 South Crew getting it done. Nailed all day, it. Every day. Shrimp boil yet to come.
Oh, it's coming.
You happy, Mike?
I'm stoked.
All right.
try to get a picture of me jumping off?
What's up, everybody? Two South crew and the party continues at Mike's house, partying with the kids in the pool. Honestly, pools in Florida aren't like exceptionally warm all year round. It's actually a little chilly, but I mean, you can still get in and not freeze your butt off.
A little
bit of music. There's Mickle back there. Oh man, that boy's got the moves like Jagger. Wow. That's how we roll, fellas. Look at this guy, man. I mean, it's just incredible. You can't beat it. You can't beat it. We didn't catch any fish today, but we're definitely having a good time. We'll see you guys later at the shrimp boil.
Bye.
Do it.
All right, everybody, and this is what it's about. The shrimp boil begins. Got the whole family involved. Look at this, chopping up. What we got here? Some potatoes. Working on some lemons.
And then...
What's going into this, Michael? What all goes in? Wait, what? Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Babe, I was telling Michael earlier that people are like, oh, you don't put up Christmas lights? I'm like, oh, I put up lights, Coors lights. But anyways, what's going into this shrimp boil, Michael?
All right, let me give you a little background. So I lived in Louisiana for about 5 years, and by far, my favorite part of Louisiana was the food there. The food culture is unbelievable. And this time of year starts crawfish season, and crawfish boils, there is not much else like it. But it is really difficult to get crawfish shipped here, because you need them live. So instead, we do everything exactly the same, but we use shrimp instead of crawfish. So what we're doing here, we got potatoes, we got andouille sausage, we have lemons, we have Zatarain's crab oil, we got the shrimp still frozen, we have portobello mushrooms,
nice.
Onions will go in there, we're gonna chop up some garlic, tons of seasonings, tons of salt, tons of delicious goodness, and you boil that, and it's a whole process. You gotta do things at certain times, put stuff in, this and that, but what comes out is just glorious goodness, and it's one of the things that I introduced to James, and when I told him I was doing a shrimp boil today,
Yeah.
He was a little bit excited.
Yeah, it's great, man. It's a great thing to do with the family. The family gets to hang out together, you know, you get to like freaking work on it together, and then you get to enjoy it together. You can't ask for much more than that. That's what Two South Crew is all about, man. Hanging out with family, enjoying this life. We'll see you guys soon when we're eating this delicious shrimp boil.
Chopping, just going like boom, and then going to the fire, and then boom. Came to boil. I just dropped all the seasonings. Zatarain's crawfish boil. A couple bags. Onions, lemons, little Creole seasoning, garlic, orange juice, a few other secret recipe things. This is the start. So now we let this boil for about 15 minutes. All that seasoning mixed up. We start. Ooh, what's happening? Dinner is coming!
Everybody, we still plug it away on the shrimp boil. Look at this. Oh my god, it looks so delicious.
It's so close. Last step is to
what?
Add the shrimp.
Oh,
so
it's
we've
coming.
Added the mushrooms, we've added the potatoes, we've added the andouille sausage. We're letting it just meld together. Boil up. The corn is in there.
coming, fellas. It
last
is
step is shrimp.
Coming.
You let that cook for like 3 minutes, and then you add the ice and you let it just meld together. The ice stops the boiling, stops the cooking process. Then you let it sit. You let all the juices suck into everything you put in.
Gonna be amazing.
That's the most important process of this all. You'll see a lot of recipes, but if you don't add ice and let it cool down and then let it all just suck the juices in, just like you let a steak marinate. After you cook it, let the juices come back in 10 minutes later. Add a lot of beers.
Yeah.
Great.
Yeah. Yeah.
But anyway.
Definitely beers are part of this process.
So good.
So close.
Got my Harry Potter glasses on. This is what I'm talking about.
All right, everybody, here's the finished product. The shrimp boil with the corn, the sausage, the shrimp. Look at that glorious tray. We are going to have a wonderful time eating this.
Oh, yes, we are, baby.
Thank you, Michael.
Oh, you're welcome, man. I mean, like, we threw that ice in, let it settle down, and it just sucked up all the wonderful juices, and now we're about to enjoy it. We built this city.
Exactly.
We built this.
Look at that. Look at that.
I don't even know.
It's gonna be wonderful. Love y'all. We'll see you real soon.
Later.